Our favourite from the week came in from Chris Wood, who suggested Alex should try fire breathing.
Oh, yes.
I am happy to say tonight, to close the show, Alex Brooker will attempt to become more inspirational than Jack Carroll by actually breathing fire in the studio.
Jesus Christ, having one leg's not enough anymore. You come over with your jokes and you ruin it for the rest of us. This used to be enough for me.
And this isn't a joke, by the way. This is not like a skill that Alex already had that we thought tied in. He has actually spent the entire afternoon today learning how to breathe fire. Here's proof.
Right. Give you a little demonstration.
Brilliant.
Feel it.
You sure?
Yeah.
Someone told me to do this a little while ago. I had a massive fist at the start of it. Hey? Neither of them have got, like, any burns around the face, which is a positive for me. Like that.
All you need now is the paraffin.
What does it taste like? Is it like Sambuca or something like that? Or is that wishful thinking?
Take a breath before you put it in your mouth.
There must be worse things you could have in your job.
Yeah.
It's like Cool Lane in Leeds on a Saturday night. It beats singing E17 again, doesn't it? So, fuck it.
Alex Brooker, if you'd like to make your way. That was actually Jack Carroll throwing down the gauntlet. That is it for the last leg this week. Would you please thank Alan Carr? Josh Whittacombe! And the fire-breathing dragon that is about to be Alex Brooker! Next week we'll be joined by sports presenter Gabby Logan, and while we're talking sport, a massive shout-out for Richard Whitehead, who's running 40 marathons in 40 days. Thanks for watching The Last Leg. I'm Adam Hills. We'll see you next week for the next leg, unless this goes horribly wrong. Ladies and gentlemen, to become inspirational, Alex Brooker!
Don't be a bell end, Josh.
Oh, God, I'm nervous.